In today's video, I'm going to look at the accessibility settings from within Foxit. Now, I've never looked at Foxit from an accessibility perspective, and so most of what you're gonna see in today's video is me simply poking around and seeing what kind of trouble I can get into. Welcome to the Accessibility Guy channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. The first thing I wanna do is open up a document. And this is a document that I believe I've already applied some accessibility to, but since we're exploring the accessibility features, the first thing I wanna do is select the accessibility tab on the top toolbar. Now from here, it looks like we have auto tag document, we have auto tag form fields, full check accessibility report, setup assistant reading order, set alternate text, and set area reading order. Interesting. And on the far left-hand side, do we have a tags button? We do. So if I right click inside of that column on the left, I can select the tags button. Awesome. And in here we have a document tag. So it did keep my structure. We have H1 P tag. We have a figure tag, H2 list, H2 list. That's awesome. So I can see the tags in here. I'm very interested to see what else we can do in terms of the tag structure. Like, what if I deleted this H1? What happens there? Let's see, we can select the text, that's good. We can right click it, but nothing is in the right click. What about from the tags button? Options, interesting. Okay, we have create tag from selection. I don't think, oh, it put it inside of our P tag, interesting. So let's try this again. I'm going to right click new tag and select heading level 1, title. What is this? Interesting. And then I'm gonna drag that content inside of that H1 tag. All right, so we do have the ability to kind of move stuff around in here. That's kind of cool. And the titles is simply going on the right-hand side of that content, which is kind of silly, but that's fine. That's actually a nice feature because this can help if you are organizing and chunking content. All right, well, I wasn't expecting this. Let's see, let's do a full check. Okay, this is kind of just pulling from Adobe Acrobat's menu, clearly, but that's not a terrible start. All right, I'm gonna go back to the tags button. Let's select this option, set alternate text. Foxit PDF editor will detect all figures in the document and display associated alt text. Okay, all right, so it found the one there. Perfect, I guess that works. Let's right click in here and I wanna see, we have contents, we have order. Let's do order, interesting. Do they have the reading order tool? All right, so it said it might mess with the exact existing tag structure. Okay, I'm not quite sure what is happening with that, but oh, here we go. So there's the reading tool. What in the world? I need to get out of this window. Go back to tags. Let's select the reading order tool and let's see what we got. We've got artifact in here. That makes sense. We can tag that content there. We've got structure types, page content, mark it as a heading 1. Okay, cool. So this is literally just like a port of the accessibility from within Adobe Acrobat. Let's go ahead and auto tag the document and let's just see what happens. I'm just curious. All right, let's go to the tags panel. Okay, so it's definitely using the old auto tagging from Adobe Acrobat. It has not implemented the new features because in the new version of Adobe Acrobat, we have that auto tag API introduction. All right, well, at least this is something. What about forms? Interesting. So we have the ability to do tooltips in here. That's good. Let's run the accessibility checker because I'm curious what it's going to flag on this. All right, forms, tagged form fields. Interesting, we can right click and fix that. That's wild to me. Oh, now we have 6 elements that are missing alt text. How funny. That's because I re-tagged it. I want to try to find this form field. Oh, okay, so right now it's tagged. That's good that it's tagged. It just put it in like a parent form tag on the top of the tags panel. In order for this to be accessible though, we would need to put it inside of a P tag because you can't have form parents. And yeah, the checkbox is there. How interesting. What else do we got? So it looks like we can make forms in there. Page templates, that's cool. Edit tooltips. Or add tooltips. Interesting. This is pretty cool. You have JavaScript options, exporting and importing. We have the ability to do a button, a checkbox, radio button, signature fields, text fields. They also have the ability to run form field recognition, and we've got a hand and select tool. What else do we got? View, interesting. So it looks like that you can do quite a bit from within Foxit. You know what I wonder if they have is the pre-flight menu. Okay, so I was able to type in pre-flight into the search bar, and it looks like it's loading, but wow. All right, I'm gonna change the dropdown from Foxit to PDF standards. And then a common one that we fix is like embedding fonts. I need to select the single wrench element. Oh yeah, here we go. Embed missing fonts. That's pretty rad that it's in here. So it does appear that we can fully make a document accessible in Foxit. Just for fun, let's test the file into PAC. So I just saved the file to my desktop and I'm going to launch the PAC 2024 tool. And let's test this file out. Wow. Yeah, we're gonna be able to make PDF UA compliant documents using Foxit. That concludes our brief overview of how to use Foxit to make a document accessible. This is the first time I've ever really dove into Foxit's accessibility capabilities. So expect future videos on how to fix some of this stuff from within Foxit. If you found this video useful, please take a second to hit that subscribe button and share it with your friends. I'm trying to get to 5,000 subscribers and all of you can really help me out. Thank you so much for joining me today and I'll see you next time.